Now that the pump has been disassembled and inspected, we're ready to start reassembly. To begin reassembly, insert the pilot piston seal retainer with the beveled side facing in on both sides of the pump. Push them in until you feel a mechanical stop. Reassemble the pilot piston bearing using the two O-rings and three backups. Be sure to use a light gravity motor oil to generously lubricate all of your O-rings and backups when you're reassembling. Insert the pilot piston bearing with its O-rings and backups into the pilot piston body. Repeat this assembly for both pilot seat retainers on each side. Place the pilot piston cap over the bearings and seat the O-rings in place. This prevents the O-ring from getting pinched later when you install the pilot piston caps. Attach one of the pilot piston caps to the pump body so that you can install the pilot piston on the other side. Use oil to lubricate the piston rod and then insert it into the main piston body. Push it until it's flush with the pilot piston bearing and then attach the other pilot piston cap. Use a screwdriver to move the pilot piston back and forth, making sure that it moves freely. If the pilot piston is stuck, loosen the bolts on the pilot piston cap until it moves freely, and then tighten the bolts and check it again. Install the main piston and make sure that it moves freely through the pump body. Insert the two O-rings in the communicating hole grooves on the piston rod gland, and place the larger O-rings on the opposite side. Now insert the two backups and O-rings in the piston rod seal retainers. Lubricate the O-rings and backups on the seal retainers with oil, then install them into the piston rod gland. Lubricate the piston rod with oil to prevent damaging the seal retainer O-rings. Make sure that the index pins are in the body, then slide the gland and the seal retainer assembly onto the piston rod and align the index pin with the hole on the gland. Repeat these steps on the other side of the pump. Next, insert O-rings and backups and the interior O-ring onto the piston seal retainer. Lubricate the O-rings and backups with oil and place the piston seal retainer and the piston onto the piston rod. Thread on the lock nut with the bevel side facing out and tighten it while holding the piston rod still with a wrench on the back side of the piston. Repeat this step on both sides. Make sure that the gland doesn't move out of place when tightening the lock nut. Make sure that the pistons and the inside of the cylinder walls are lubricated with oil, then slide the cylinders onto the pistons. Install the cylinder head O-rings and lubricate them with oil. Place the bolts into the cylinder head and mount it on the cylinder. Make sure that the tubing fitting is in the right place and tighten the bolts in a star pattern, just like you would the lug nuts on the wheel. In the newer style pumps, you'll have gaskets that will go underneath the removable port plates. Place the O-rings on the main piston valve housing and the pilot piston valve housing, then install the D-slide guides. Remove the legs closest to the main piston valve housing so that there will be room to tighten the bolts on the pilot piston housing. Coat the D-slide in oil and place it on the main piston valve housing. The oil will keep it in place while you install it in the pump body. Insert the bolts that hold the pilot piston valve housing in place. Now you can reinstall the legs closest to the main piston valve housing. Now install the tubing. Start with the shorter of the two U-shaped tubes, with one end on the main piston valve housing and the other end on the pilot piston cap. Hand tighten the fitting caps so that they don't cross thread, and then tighten them down until they're snug. Install the longer U-shaped tube on the other main piston valve housing fitting and the pilot piston cap. Coat the D-slide in oil and place it on the pilot piston valve housing and lubricate the O-ring. Insert the pilot piston valve housing into the pump body and rotate it slightly to be able to install your pilot piston tubing. Hand start the pilot piston tubing and then bolt down the pilot piston valve housing. Now you can tighten down the pilot piston tubing and then stand the pump up on its legs. Hand start the L-shaped tubing on the needle valve side and use a wrench to move the tubing elbow into position as you push the tubing into place. Tighten the fittings until snug and then repeat these steps for the other side. Next, insert the discharge seats into the block along with their O-rings. Now you can place the upper and the lower O-rings on the check valves. Be sure to lubricate the check valves with oil and insert them into the block. Put the O-rings onto the check valve caps and install them onto the discharge block. Verify that the check valves are moving freely by shaking the discharge block. If they are installed properly, you will be able to hear them moving back and forth. Now attach the discharge block to the pump body. Put the O-rings onto the suction seats and lubricate them with oil before you install them into the suction block. Use the suction seat tool to put the seat into the suction block. Tap the seat into place, being careful not to shear the O-ring. You should feel a little bit of resistance. Place the upper and lower O-rings on the check valves. Lubricate the check valves with oil and insert them into the block. Place the O-rings on the check valve caps and install them into the suction block. Verify that the check valves are moving freely by shaking the suction block. You should be able to hear them moving back and forth. Now you can place the two O-rings on the back face of the suction block. Next, bolt the discharge and the suction blocks to the pump body. Tighten the check valve caps by hand with a crescent wrench so that you don't over-tighten them. Our last step will be to assemble the needle valves. Thread the needle valve stems into the needle valve housing. Now place the O-rings and backups around the stem. The new style glycol pump has a groove in the needle valve body for an O-ring. If this groove isn't there, don't use the O-ring provided in the repair kit. Thread the needle valve assembly into the control valve housing. Repeat all of the same steps for the other needle valve. Install the valve covers and attach the needle valve handles. That concludes our repair. If you have any questions or need any information on the Kimray tools that I use throughout this video, reach out to your local Kimray rep or visit us at kimray.com.